I begin with José María Álvarez. Nombre escrito en el agua. Como la hidra a una pared vieja, el deseo se agarra a mi alma. Si pudiera borrar su imagen, yo era feliz sin ella. Porque la suerte puso ante mí su cuerpo, el brillo de su piel, su mirada de oro. Yo era feliz sin ella. Conversaba bajo el sol del ocaso con un amigo, hablamos de Stendhal y yo era feliz. Y de pronto cruzaste jugando con un gato, me miraste, rías y al fondo el mar que separa los mundos. Es la luz de la adolescencia, me dijo aquel amigo. Habrá muerto en 6 meses apagada. Yo era feliz sin ti y verdaderamente 6 meses antes o después nada serías. Pero la tarde aquella hora, como el poeta puede parar el tiempo en sus versos, mostró la más hermosa que serías. Y la belleza condenó a mi alma y un atroz exilio, pues aunque ahora te tuviese ya no tendría la que fuiste ese instante. Nunca podría tenerla y mis ojos erraron por siempre. Yo moría odiando mis manos que serán polvo sin haber tocado el milagro. Name writ in water. Like the ivy in an old wall, desire clung to my soul. If I could only erase your image, I was happy without her. Why did luck place your body before me, the shine of your skin, your golden gaze? I was happy without her. I was talking under the sun about the sunset with a friend. We spoke about Stendhal. I was happy. And suddenly you appeared playing the cat. You looked at me, laughed, and in the background the sea that separates the worlds. It is the light of adolescence, that friend said to me. It will be dead in 6 months, quenched. I was happy without you. And truthfully, 6 months before or after, you could have been nothing. But the evening of that hour, like the poet stops time in his poems, you showed the most beautiful you could be, and the beauty condemned my soul to a cruel exile. So even if you were here now, I would not have what that moment was. I will never have her, and my eyes will wander forever, and I will die hating my hands that will be dust without having touched the miracle. The José María Álvarez. Un aplauso para Beatriz Villacañas, su primera vez leyendo en la Universidad de Limerick. Thank you. Applause for Beatriz.
Thank you, John. Good evening to everybody. It is a real pleasure for me and an honor to be here in Limerick at Limerick University. My relations with Ireland are profound and very long, both in a personal aspect and also professional aspect, since I teach Irish literature at the University in Madrid. And well, I want to stress the fact that I am absolutely delighted to be here and surrounded by all of you and members of my family, friends, dear people in all, and of course Austin the musician and John and Liam Liddy, great friends of mine, and their respective families. In this first part, I'm going to read two poems, which have been translated into English, or were translated into English, by the Irish poet Michael Smith. Here is my recognition to him as well. I'm going to read these two poems in Spanish and English. Íntimo astro del tiempo. En el instante cósmico y preciso se engendró un viaje astral, con el tiempo de lo infinitamente grande y lo pequeño. Y comenzamos a escrutar el universo y su misterio. Todo él hecho espejo de la galaxia escondida del cerebro, de lo infinitamente grande y lo pequeño. porque el espacio, con todo su secreto, se mira en el enigma de la música estelar de cada beso. Intimate star of time. In the cosmic and precise instant, a sidereal voyage is engendered with the time of the infinitely big and the small. And we begin to scrutinize the universe and its mystery. Every fact, a mirror of a galaxy hidden in the brain. For space, with all its secret, is seen in the enigma of the stellar music of each kiss. And the second poem is The Fall and the Ascent. La caída. Caí de la razón al pensamiento, y de este a la idea, y de la idea caí a la palabra, de la palabra al sonido, y del sonido al silencio. Entonces supe algo. Subí, atravesando espacios, al tiempo más remoto, y llamé a Dios. ¿Por qué? Le pregunté. La respuesta sigue allí, y yo siento otra vez la gravedad del suelo. The fall. I fell from reason to thought, and from that to the idea. From the idea I fell to the word, from the word to sound, and from sound to silence. Then I knew something. Ascent. I climbed, traversing spaces to the most distant time, and I called God. Why? I asked him. His reply went beyond me, and I felt once more the gravity of Earth. Thank you very much.